Salutations, celestial sightseers. I'm David Fuller. Welcome to Eyes on the Sky. What's up this week? There are some stars quite close in the winter sky. Let's look at a few, but first considering their distance and luminosity. The brightest in the night sky is also one of the closest, at 8.6 light years, Sirius. Easily found just over 20 degrees from Orion's belt, it shines at magnitude negative 1.4, three times brighter than Alpha Centauri and Arcturus, the number 3 and 4 brightest stars. So if it's close, it should be brighter, right? Not necessarily. Rigel in Orion is the 7th brightest star, but is 860 light years away. And some close stars are very dim. Barnard's star is 6 light years away and only magnitude 10. What's interesting about Sirius is that while it is nearly twice the mass and size of our Sun, it is more than 25 times brighter. So if we were orbiting Sirius, our Sun would not appear nearly as bright in the sky as Sirius does to us here. Certainly it would still be quite noticeable, but as a more average-looking second magnitude star. But check this out. Sirius has an 8th magnitude white dwarf companion that packs almost our entire Sun's mass into a sphere the size of our Earth. Can we split these two and therefore see this white dwarf? Well, yes, but it takes the right conditions and some special techniques, which I've outlined at Eyes on the Sky. Another nearby star with a white dwarf companion in a moment. There are three stars just above Rigel in Orion. The first two are Epsilon and Tau. And along that same line is this third magnitude star, Cursa, or Beta Eridani, is actually in Eridanus, the river. Check out the nifty triangle of stars here too. Beta is an A-class star, 66 above right is a B-class, and 68 above left is an F-class star. See the color differences? After pausing to view those, next make three hops of about 4 degrees each this way. First, follow a line from those top two stars to fourth magnitude Omega Eridani, which bisects these two dimmer 6th magnitude stars on either side of it. Continue on another 4 degrees, stopping for a moment at this lovely blue and orange binocular pair of 46 Eridani, both also at 6th magnitude. 4 degrees more leads to this rather random collection of 4th to 6th magnitude stars. Now the brightest one is Omicron 1 Eridani, but we want to focus on the next brightest one, Omicron 2. This star is only 16.5 light years from Earth, and is one of the few orange-appearing K-class dwarf stars visible naked eye. It has a white dwarf companion at magnitude 9.5, probably the easiest white dwarf to find and see, too, as the primary's glare does not overpower it. At 1.5 times the size of Earth, but containing half of the Sun's mass, the average density of the white dwarf is a quarter of a ton per cubic centimeter. Almost any small telescope of 60 millimeters or larger can show this star with sufficiently dark skies or dark adaptation. But beyond that, the white dwarf itself has a companion, a red dwarf star, presently at its furthest angular distance from our perspective at 9 arc seconds. At magnitude 12, however, very dark skies or a 6-inch or larger scope will be needed to spot it. The moon reaches first quarter phase by Wednesday. Take note of the craters along the terminator for the most dramatic views. Over the next 2 months, Jupiter will make a beeline towards M35 in Gemini, but will stop well short of it by winter's end. That's all for this week. Keep your eyes in the sky and your outdoor lights aimed down so we can all see what's up. I'm David Fuller, wishing you clear and dark skies.